Hello friends and everyone, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. In this video, we are going to talk about right to left flow direction in .NET Maui. Defaultly, when you create a new project, the direction flow, it is left to right. That is when I have a text box here. So if I decide to type, you see it is from left to right. So if I type in left to right. Now, what if in case I want to start from right to left? So can we implement right to left flow direction in .NET Maui? Yes, we can. So we have to write some classes in it, and let's see how to work with that. So let's go to our page, and here we are going to create an extension. That's a folder whereby we're going to name the folder as an extension. So let's do that. First of all, I'm going to close the debugging mode. So we're going to add a new folder, and now let's name this as extensions. So this extensions, let's create a class for this. So add a new class, and let's say flow direction extension. Let's give it in that way. So flow direction extension. Okay. So this, what we're going to do now, we want to inherit from the interface of iMarkup. So iMarkup extensions. And now with this extension, it, since it's an interface, it has an inbuilt method that it needs to override. Now you see we have this provide value, and it is injecting of what the iService provider with its object. So let's see. What can we do again? Let's also create another class in the same extension. So let's add a class. And by this, we're going to name it as change direction. So let's see what we can do from here. So change. So you want to change the direction of a text when we decide to type. So change direction. Now this change direction, let's make it as public. Now let's create in here, let's create a public flow direction. And now with this, we are going to name this. So let's see if we can have a string key for now. Then we navigate this to the flow direction. Aside from this, what we can do again here is to let's set the direction that you want to, the flow direction, that is the left to right. You know, default one is the left to right, right? So let's set it over here. So we have public and we say flow direction. And now we give it a name of the same flow direction. And now here we want to have get and set access set. Now we want to set default to what? Flow direction. So flow direction dot, and you want to use the left to right. That is the default one. Also, let's specify a static. So we say public, then we're going to have a static change direction. So change direction, and now here we create an instance, and now we have our get and set access set, and we're going to create new change direction. Okay, so change direction here, it is a method here that we are calling. So we are creating a new change direction anytime that you want to call this instance. Now the next thing that we can do here is we have to go for this flow direction extension, and I implement method or interface implementation here, and we say var binding. So it's equal to new, and our new binding. Now this new binding, let's specify here the source. So the source is equal to change direction dot instance. And now here, let's return binding. So let's save this. And aside from doing this, the next thing that we can do here is, let's go to our styles. So we go to resources and we have our styles. And here, this style.xml. So we open this style. And let's search for style target type of page. And now we have to add this setter. So let's add this setter here. And property, we set this to flow direction. And now we set the value to, so extension, flow direction. But before this works, we have to, so let's close this first. So let's add this namespace. And next, and now here, we say extension. And now we call it CL dash. And here, we are using demo. So we're going to use namespace. Then the name of the project as demo dot extension. So this extension, what we are using over here. So now let's go in there and I'll check for the page. So let's see. Okay, so we see now it is all set now. Now what you have to do next is, after setting up this, we go to the app. You know, when the app starts, it starts from this app.xml page. So let's go to the code behind file here. And now let's register, let's change the direction here. So in when the app starts, we want to call this change direction. So change direction dot, now the instance that we created dot flow direction is equal to flow direction dot. And now here we want to use right to left. So let's save this. And now let's run this application and see. Okay, so we have an exception here. So it is saying that the exception has been thrown by the target of an invocation. And now let's say, so let's go to the flow direction extension and specify a key name here. So let's specify the path. So we say path is equal to, then here we are going to specify a key name. So let's say this is key name. Now let's save this and now let's run this again. So when you're able to do this, the only thing that you need to do here is to come to this app.xml page here. Now you see we can toggle between right to left and left to right. Create your extension and add your extension, link them. And now when you are done, this is the main page where you have to set up over here. So if it is a left to right, you can set it over here. And if it is a right to left too, you can do it over here. So let's see our page. Now if I decide to type, let's type, you can see I'm typing from here. So let's say the direction flow, you know, so the direction flow, as you can see from here, it is typing from, is it right to left. So the direction flow is right to left. So we see this from right to left. And you want to, if you want to start from left to right too, it is a matter of changing this. So instead of this right to left, you can just come here and now we say left to right. And this is going to work. So let's restart this and see what we have now. So let's see. Now, as soon as we start to type, you can see, now you can see it is from left to right. Also, if you check the documentation for this Maui app, I have the downloaded PDF over here. Now, you can also change the flow direction over here, that is from right to left or from left to right. You can specify it with that is a label or any view at all. So instead of creating a generic one to handle the whole page through direction, you can just specify it specifically to the view or the control that you want to use. So let's have a look at it here with an example. Go to our page. Now you see here, we have it from left to right. Let's go to our main page. Now this main page, we have this text box. And now this text box, let's specify the flow direction. And we can say this is left to right. Now let's specify another one. And you know, the default one, it is left to right. So when you check the app, xml.cs, it is left to right. So even if you don't specify this flow direction, it is left to right. So with this, you can decide to leave this. So let's change this to right to left. And now let's create another one. And that one, we're not going to do anything to it. And defaultly, it's going to be from left to right. Now let's save this also. And now let's run this application and see. Okay, so our app is now loaded. Now let's see the first one here. It is the entry without flow direction. And default one is left to right. So we want to start from our left to the right. Now let's see. So left to right. And as you can see, it is left to right. Now the second text box here, it is the flow direction. It is right to left. So we can specify, let's see. And here it is right to left. So even without creating a generic class, overriding the class, creating an extension to have a full control of the flow direction of the whole content page, you can still specify or be specific in the views. So when you pass in the view, if you want the section or the direction, you specify the flow direction and use it. But you know, when you have a text box whereby you want the whole text box to be left to right, unless you specify this flow direction on each of the text box. So in such case, when you create an extension, you get it once, and it's going to affect the entire content or the entire application. So that is it. If you want to toggle between the direction flow, either to type from left to right or to right to left, you can use this extension and you can implement this in a simple way. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like what I'm doing, give me a thumbs up. You can subscribe to the channel. Check the playlist. We have a lot of lessons and projects for you over there. Both Maui application and also Blazor applications as well, or Blazor web app. So you can have a look on these lessons and projects. Thank you and take care of yourself. And I'm going to see you in the next video.